Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to get started with the Vue PDF Viewer component. Using the Vue PDF Viewer, you can load, view, review, and print PDF files. It provides the best viewing experience with interactive features such as zooming, scrolling, text searching, bookmarks, table of contents, and more. Now, I will explain how to integrate the PDF Viewer into the Vue project. Open the terminal window and install the Vue CLI by running the command npm install -g Vue CLI. I will create a new Vue project by running the command Vue create and provide the app name My Vue App. Initiating a new project prompts me to choose the type of project to be used for the current application. I choose Vue 3. Next, change to the created project directory using the command cd my Vue app command. Next, install the Syncfusion Vue PDF Viewer package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-pdf-viewer. --save. This installed the Syncfusion Vue PDF Viewer package and its dependencies. You can also ensure that they are installed by checking the @syncfusion folder in the node modules. Before using Syncfusion components, you need to register the Syncfusion license key. You can learn how to obtain and register a free license key to use our Vue components from the documentation. And you can find the link in the description below. Open the main.js file under the source folder and import the register license module from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Then, register the Vue trial or license key using the register license method. Next, I will open the app.vue file and remove the default codes added in template, script, and style section for better clarity. Then, in the script section, import the PDF Viewer component and toolbar modules from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue PDF Viewer package. Next, use the components plugin to set the value of the EJS PDF Viewer key to the PDF Viewer component, with the PDF Viewer component as its argument. It will register the PDF Viewer component along with its required child directives globally. Then, inject the toolbar module into the PDF Viewer component by using provide option to specify the PDF Viewer key and set its value to an array containing toolbar. Next, in the style section, I import the required CSS styles for the PDF Viewer component along with dependency styles. Within this template section, I will include the EJS PDF Viewer tag. Adding this tag will add a PDF Viewer to your application and save the changes. To run the Vue application, I will need to use the npm run serve command in the terminal. Now, let me move on to the output page. You can see the PDF Viewer component rendered with the default toolbar. By clicking the folder option in the toolbar, you can load a PDF file from the local path. Notice the error here. This is because the PDF Viewer has a server-side dependency to load PDF files. Let's see how to download and execute the web API project. You can clone or download the project from the GitHub repository, and you can find the link to the repository in the description below. To register a license key in the server side, you will need to open the startup.cs file in a text editor and find the configure method. In the configure method, you can see a line of code that invokes and registers the key using the register license method. Assign your actual trial or license key to the variable named license key. You can use the same key in both client-side and server-side and save the changes. If you are using .NET 6.0 ASP.NET Core, you will need to open the program.cs file. And the process for registering the license key is the same. Now, open a command prompt in this location and run the .NET restore command to restore the required packages. Then, run the .NET run command to start the web service. This will start the PDF Viewer server instance and make it available at the specified local host and port number in the properties. Launch settings.json file. Navigate to the PDF Viewer web controls URL in a web browser to test the service. Now, our PDF Viewer server is up and running. Next, in the script section, I am adding a data property called service URL and setting its value to the PDF Viewer service. Then, in the template section, I am binding the service URL property to the EJS PDF Viewer component. This allows the PDF Viewer to communicate with the service and render the PDF files. As you can see, the PDF file I selected is loaded in the PDF Viewer component properly. Now, I will show you how to load the PDF document from the URL into the Vue PDF Viewer component. In the script section, I am adding a data property called DocumentPath and setting its value to the path of a specific PDF file that you want to display. Then, in the template section, I am binding the document path property to the EJS PDF Viewer component so that the PDF Viewer can use this information to display the specified PDF file while initializing. The PDF Viewer will now load and display the PDF document from the URL passed. In this video, I showed you how to set up the Syncfusion PDF Viewer server-side web service and integrate the PDF Viewer component into a Vue application. You also saw how to load a PDF document from a URL to the Vue PDF Viewer. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire Vue component suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.